Hello, and welcome to the first OpenTTD co-op game overview. We're looking at the last ProZone game at the moment, which is 19, if I recall correctly. My name is Sirius DC. I'm here today with V453,000.
Yeah, just for a good number. Hi.
I just call him V, everyone does. This is a special game. The game was basically no new GRFs, original terrain generator, and using Lev 4.
Yeah, the engines just turned out to be totally uncontrollable, as we always thought. Yeah. So the basic challenge was just to get the engines and deal with it.
Basically, V dubbed it Chaos Mode.
Yeah.
Basically, the Lev 4 engine is the fastest engine in the game, as we know, but it's also the engine which has the poorest acceleration.
Yeah.
Takes about 50 to 60 tails to get to full speed.
That's just insane.
Ooh. It's insane. If you take my general rule of building priorities, which is train length times 1.5 to double the train length.
Yeah, that's just playing badly here.
300 tail priors, which is... well, impossible to manage because it's... well, you can't get any traffic on the network.
Yeah. Well, I would look now at the parameters or qualities what the trains have, actually. So, well, we can see here that the trains accelerate, like, super badly. It's just terrible acceleration. So, if we look, for example, at one of our biggest, like, Bone Hubs, the Bone Hub 5, you can see that there's like six lines everywhere, and there's barely any trains. Well, so, of course, for the whole game, we were saying to ourselves, look, we just can't expect some full lines and total train density everywhere and super traffic, because we just can't do it. And that's everything related to the priorities and styles of mergers we are going to show you in this game. And that's just...
I'm basically looking at the mainline north of BBH5 at the moment.
Yeah.
And the lane going south is very full for this game. And for any other game, it would be like, well, maybe 4 hours into the game.
Yeah, so we could get 2,000 more trains, right? So boring, just more trains.
It looks like the network is like... well, this line is very, very busy, but... on general, the network looks like used for maybe 1/3 of the maximum capacity, but it is about full capacity with these trains.
Yeah, that's basically because of the dangerous threshold, because when trains start slowing down, it's basically they're screwed. Just, they slow down and they start getting into evil mode, and they just don't merge too well, and it's bad. You just have to keep it running as we move here.
To combat this, we have, well, tried several techniques. We decided beforehand that we wanted an old school game, so everything very simple. Loads of combo stuff, old school kind of joiners and mergers and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I'm just looking at random parts of the network at the moment.
Yeah, I would just mention the few rules that we made in the start of the game. So, probably the most important one is the trains that horrific acceleration, where that we decided we will build no tunnels at all in the main line or bridge car. So, which resulted in completely different construction of the sideline hubs, because suddenly you treat the main line like something blessed or something you can't even touch, because you just have to keep trying.
That is actually very, very old school.
Yeah.
Like in my first games before you even joined, it was the same. We always tunneled the sidelines and never the main line. Well, nowadays we, well, mostly tunnel the main line and actually have the...
yeah.
The line which is going to join or split or whatever, not tunneled at all.
Exactly. That's just... it's different. It's, be it engines or just different techniques used, different train density expected even. Because when you looked at the last public server games, a few games back, when we used the AL10, which accelerates basically instantly when we replay to the ProZone 5, it's just totally different. It's just everything behaves differently. You get mergers which have one train behind another, and just you have to deal with everything differently. And that's why this game is so interesting, because in every part of the network, it's just not many trains, you could say. And you need extreme amount of lines. And for example, if we look at the mergers, if we look at, for example, BBH5, the huge merger on the right, it's just what we see or what we have seen already. But in this case, it's just so much special. Because if you look, the choices have just one tunnel for the five lines. There's just not much. But thanks to the fact that the train just come in so long interval by the terrible acceleration, well, they just don't mind it. The gaps are just fine. And the same about the combo signals used there. Just with normal trains, you couldn't afford it ever. That would just be instantly wrong.
If we would use the DB set, this joiner couldn't have been built like this at all.
Yeah, definitely.
It would first off have double tunnels.
Yeah, but when you try to build double tunnels in here, you just get into huge problems with design and with space.
Well, double tunnels don't really... Well, they do work, but it's not of much use because, well, the trains are very far apart and they are so quick that everything which involves joining is basically a mess.
Yeah, that's the point. Well, this game just
works. If the train needs to stop, it stops completely, and it needs, well, most of the time trains need distance between two hubs or possibly even two backbone hubs. To
just speed up.
Get to full speed. I can show you, if we look at BBH1 to the north, when the trains arrive at the splitter, it's about when they reach full speed. And there are other requirements for this game, of course. If we just look at the town drop, which you can see right away, it is huge. And it has a reason, because trains load and unload very slow, because it's the default set on gradual loading.
Yeah.
So we basically need loads and loads of tracks to load and unload trains.
Yeah, so the entrance of the station is just empty, and the platforms, all the trains just stand there, wait.
This size is needed, even if not all platforms are filled at the same time. It is possibly a bit oversized, but not too much.
Yeah, that's the point, not too much. Well, when we talk about this station, it's interesting about the exit. Because nowadays, we don't use it very often in our games.
I'm the only one who builds it.
Yeah, it just breaks. It's a strong train or whatever. Because here, it's just, again, the trains that allow it.
Yeah, usually it doesn't work too well. In this case, it works a bit better, but...
Yeah, it works.
It's a nice kind of joiner, but it's very complicated to build and to get right.
Yeah, well, the main danger is that it's still huge. So, if you build it in a normal game, it just doesn't work ideally. Well, why would you just do that?
I would actually call it pretty small for the distance between the station and when it's reduced to two lines, even if it started like 10 plus lines, possibly even 16.
Yeah, well, when you look at the factory drop...
The problem with this kind of joiner is that you... I have to keep track of where which line is going, because we've seen before in our old BBH5 that some trains from three different lines only had the choice to go to one line eventually. So it wasn't of much use to have that kind of joiner, because, well, it was basically like a three line to one line.
Yeah, sure. Well, that's the danger. But actually, as you were mentioning here, with the merger, actually, a huge difference, because we always use this as a station exit, like, never differently. But here, in this game, we just tried something like which is now in DBH2, which is a merger of this size and this kind. Well, not that size, but the style of it. So, when we said that when we get such a huge amount of clients, like behind the station, or just similar amount, we could just apply the same techniques for the merger and merge the lines the same way. And well, it worked. Well, the only problem is again that it's quite hard to build, and mainly it's very, very dangerous because you just don't even know if it's going to work.
Indeed, and it is very hard to maintain and upgrade.
Yeah, you just need suddenly two more lines and
if you want to upgrade it properly, you basically always need to rebuild it. There is no way of just adding a couple of extra lines.
Yeah, exactly. Well, that was in the end why the other style of the merger that we discussed earlier was in the end preferred for this game.
Yeah.
And we just ended up expanding for six lines. Nobody really felt like building the same things again, completely from the scratch.
I've got to show something else, the exit of the factory drop.
Yeah, that's a whole different story. That's huge.
It is very huge, but it has the simple 3-2 style.
Yeah.
But in the end, we needed to get all the different exit lanes from it into only six lanes, which basically became a mess and is the main problem area in the current game.
Well, that was just where it was somehow random, or just deal with it as you can, but
We just swapped some lines over and merged random lines into other random lines, and well, it didn't work at the end. We needed Pathfinder traps and all that kind of stuff.
Well, now it works. It's a bit slow, but
yeah, it is better than it was before, but it could still use some improvements.
Yeah.
And of course, we have the entry, which we've all seen the time lapses of, I hope.
Yeah, the entry is just great, you know, but when you see this, or the goods drop, which is just four or six lines, and how do you expand this? You just have to demolish it and build it all again. That's just effort.
Yeah, I can remember the goods drop, of which the exit is also very nice. It is my style, but
yeah,
with a twist.
The exit is nice, because you can expand it, you just add another row of it, and merge it somehow. That's fine. You don't have to delete it completely. You can see the sign on the left that we rebuilt it and bigger and bigger, and then on the right and even end on, and that's just fine. But the entrance, you just have to build it completely, just delete it all and go together.
Yeah, basically, there are like 15 or more hours put into the station alone.
Yeah, this is just ridiculous. But what I would like to bring on there is the steel mill, or the coal drop, which is just a whole different story, because we didn't rebuild anything there. All the stations are original.
Just kept expanding. If we look at this, I'm looking at the original coal drop station now.
Yeah.
This is the original coal drop station, and we have the second part of the coal drop station, which was previously the steel pickup station, but just basically just got, well, because it was accessible from every direction, we just decided to use that as a drop too, and instead build a secondary steel pickup, which has a bypass for BBH3.
Yeah, well, that's basically what Chaos Game offers. You can do anything, anytime, because you don't have any set design or system or whatever. But sure, that's just the advantage.
Yeah. But the bypass is very useful here, because it removes the load from BBH3.
Yeah.
The steel trains travel over the Southern ML, which was built later than the rest of the network, by the way. Well, most of the network. And it goes to BBH4, and then goes to the factory drop.
Yeah, this was also a very important shortcut, because it just, again, saved a lot of work, and the traffic was just better spread than the map in general.
Yeah, so we've used different kinds of expansion here. We've basically just repurposed some stations, but other stations we've completely rebuilt.
Yeah.
It is safe to say that most of the, well, everything in the network has been rebuilt.
Or yeah, pretty much.
Expanded, of course. And some parts have even been rebuilt like 3 or 4 times. The only thing that hasn't been completely rebuilt, I think, is SLH-9 and possibly SLH-11. And, yeah, maybe 10 nice. Too.
Well, it's a nice game, and if you look at it, there's only 1,000 trains, which in general wouldn't be that much, but of these trains, it's just an insane number. If you look at file transport, which has 4 times bigger map than 1,000 trains, and it was a huge success at the time.
It was until basically when you came, it was the biggest game.
Yeah.
You've kind of reinvented co-op,
well,
I think.
ProZone Game 5 was the biggest game ever, like, for years. It was just unmatched.
ProZone Game 5 basically turned out to be our second go at PAL transport.
Right. But, you know, the record that was beaten last public server game, that was the first game that actually beaten ProZone Game 5. Until then, the record was just unbeaten. Ever, anyway.
There was, of course, a logic game which had, like, 3,000 trains.
Yeah, but about 750 of them were just logic, so...
that's true. So, it is very, very different.
Yeah. It also, if you look at it, well, the current public server game was with completely different trains. They accelerate almost instantly or in comparison to LEV3, which is different. Again, if your trains accelerate well, you instantly have to connect more full of them. Easy. But why I think that public server game was great was because there's water everywhere. You look at the map, it's like water island, alright, with water. and suddenly you look at the train count, you have almost 2.7k trains. It's just...
It is insane. Like, my PC wasn't able to handle it at all. Yeah.
Well, mine was somehow.
Yeah, mine is usually very good at handling the big train games, but it wasn't on that game.
Yeah. You know, maybe we could mention the fail-safe solution here, or even more solution for the bridges here, in the tunnel, where you could just...
Which part are you talking about currently?
For example, like we have 5, where there it is. Several times, but I don't think we will see it in action because the evil mode is just gone for now. But it's just that you use the basic signals instead of any free signals or PBS as we usually like. And I even remember myself as I was telling everybody how it's on to just build basic signals, but well, it has a use as we can see here. Because under normal circumstances, the train is going free signals and PBS, and just is waiting for the new tunnel to open up. It starts slowing down, and that's an endless process, as we all know it, even more. But if we use the normal block signals, then it's just one time it fails. It just chooses the wrong full tunnel. And at that point, the whole, as the two tunnels, are taken just as one. As if there weren't ever 2. And in that case, the trains automatically space out for the gap of the one tunnel, and in that case, they just get rid of the evil mode, which is tremendously helpful with those trains, because once these super fast but badly accelerating trains get into evil mode, there's no way how they are going to help themselves. So that was a huge issue.
If a train slows down and there's another train coming,
yeah,
then there is no way to avoid a temporary jam at all.
Yeah, that's pretty much.
Like, any train slowing down on the main line is basically bad. But, like mentioned before, we can't build priorities to avoid it because, well, mainly trains can ignore signals unless we have very, very long signal blocks.
Yeah.
And very, very long priorities.
Yeah. And well, even if you do the deepest theory of all theories and everything theoretical, then still you can never have a network where not a single train slows down until it's a point to point. They always have to merge somewhere, and some trains will always slow. So it's just
trains will, of course, always slow because one train has to wait for another train.
Yeah, and the probability that they will meet is just it is.
Well, even with if you have two trains which only have one place to merge in a network, they eventually will meet.
Yeah.
So, and because we have like over 1,000 trains, we have loads of trains meeting at all the at well most of the time. I haven't even looked at oil, by the way, which I'm doing now, which is. Well, the station is basically way, way, way too big for the amount of traffic that is possible on one line.
The older refinery. Yeah, that's just a bit too long. You know, I feared that the trains might suddenly come and swarm the station if they can, really, because the platform requirements are huge. But also that the problem of those merged pickup and drop entries. Because you can't say if you expect, you know, full load of drop trains or full load of pickup trains. So, well, here I prepared for both situations. It's not perfect, it looks terrible, it's empty, but, you know, it's safe.
Yeah, it is. Well, it is, in essence, it is quite a good idea, but the station just got too big and the overflow.
It's unnecessary, and the overhaul would ensure that it doesn't really do anything bad. I mean, if you use half of the size, as you can see on the expansion, just fine, by far.
And we've had the overflow jam before, of course. I still like the mess of SLH9.
Well, that's fine. if you look where it's placed, then you can see on the left there is the big radio tower on the mountain, so it keeps you from terraforming that down. And on the right side of the hub, there's another one, again on hill. And then there are just some industries, the sawmill is very low in the near the sea level, maybe like on level 1 or 2. So again, it just makes you deal with the landscape that's there. You just can't terraform the hell out of it and be fine. Like, it's hard, but it got messy and well, it works somehow.
I've had trouble with the landscape when I started to build it, actually, when it was still a two-lane main line. And yeah. Somehow, Vinny has managed to upgrade it to, like, 4 lanes, which he deserves enormous respect and kudos for, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Even though it is as messy as this, but to be honest, I quite like messy hubs and spaghetti. And if you just look at the east side of the hub, it is one big mess, but it looks yeah. very good.
Yeah, mess indeed, but, well, actually, mess looks nice.
It is nice to have something like BBH5, which is
overly
yeah,
plain
and
boring.
Stuff.
Yeah.
It is boring, but at the same time, it is nice to look at. Because
yeah,
it's so stylized, but spaghetti is still.
And at the same time, when do you actually get 6 lines next to each other going in the same direction? Inside the hub, that's just extreme. Yeah. Well, it's fine to see how the network starts with 1 or 2 lines and ends up being as this, because really, almost nothing stays.
Network plan for a bit. Like, in this network plan, you see like one single main line from east to west. But in the end of the game, there is also one in the south because, well, soon in the game, we realized that the middle main line would have to be huge to handle all the trains.
Yeah, and right now, in a proper plan, you would also have to do this for steel because just systematically, it's not there in the one half.
Yeah, if you make an extra island with the actual plan, It would look somewhat like test.
Yeah, pretty much. Do this.
And I was about to build that.
Yeah, well, it's not too important. But it's just nice to show the flexible solutions that you have.
Yeah, and that's the good thing of playing with on the ProZone, of course, and with a chaos kind of network. You can get away with this stuff without becoming a huge mess. Well, BBH1, which was a nice compact hub, but it's very easy to expand because of
it. Yeah, well, very originally it was quite funny because I tried something where we were all about the no tunnels or main line and all that, and I was just trying to always have one line which splits without the tunnels, and of course the other directions splits with the tunnels, and then always merge one of them without tunnels and one of them with tunnels. So you certainly know which part to prioritize. And then, for example, make something like normally called broken priority, that the one tunnel just prioritize and not the other one, like if you forgot it. Because then you just detect if the tunnels go wrong and it's an evil mode or whatever else. So you fix that at that point. But until then, the trains are still allowed to go there and merge. So, well, you know, that's again just the concept that didn't work in the end too well because it was just unexpandable and too harsh. But
yeah.
It was interesting at the very least, but unfortunately it didn't remain. So.
Some concepts were very good in concept, but in the end didn't work. I hope you guys enjoyed this first, well, walkthrough-ish discussion of not our latest ProZone game. I think the Logic One has been finished already, or hasn't it?
No, it's almost complete.
Okay, so it is our last ProZone game. We've seen time-lapses of this game, mainly of the factory, which you can check, and I probably will add an annotation here to those videos.
Well, to just conclude it, I would probably thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed it, and I would just like to say why this game is so exceptional. It's so exceptional because we just managed to deal with those strengths somehow.
We've